here to work. You're not in a theater, this is a classroom, no fault at all. This is a master class. Singing is serious business. We are going to roll up our sleeves and work. I appreciate your welcome, but enough is enough. Basta, fini, eh? So how is everyone? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I don't believe in microphones. Singing is first of all about projection. So is speech. People are forgetting how to listen. They want everything blasted at them. Listening takes concentration. If you can't hear me, it's your fault. You're not concentrating. I don't get any louder than this. So come down closer or leave. Not takers? What, you're all scared of me, eh? Is that it? I don't bite, I promise you. I bark quite a bit, actually, but I don't bite. I don't know what you're expecting. What did they tell you? I hope you're not expecting me to sing. Well, we shall see what we shall see. All right, so let's begin. Where is the first student? Who is the first student? Are they here? When I was a student, I never missed a lesson, never not once. I was never late for one either. In fact, I was usually early. I never wanted to leave the conservatory. I lived, ate, and slept music. Music is a discipline. Too many of you are looking for the easy way out, shortcuts. No. If you want to have a career as I did, then I'm not boasting now. I am not one to boast. You must be willing to subjugate yourself. Is that a word? Subjugate yourself to the music. Always the music. You are its servant. You are here to serve the composer. The composer is God. In Athens, and this was during the war, I often went to bed hungry, but I walked to the conservatory and back every day, 6 days a week, and sometimes my feet were bleeding because I had no proper shoes. I don't tell you this to melodramatize, or no. I tell you to show you who I am. Discipline, courage, here, right here, from the guts. These lights. Who is in charge of these lights? Is someone in charge of these lights? May we have the lights in the auditorium off, please? This is really terrible. We can't work under these conditions. I'm not going to ask a student to come out here until these lights are taken care of. This is what I was talking about. Attention must be paid to every detail. The lights, your wig, the amount of stage dust. A career in a theater demands total concentration, 100% detail. You think I'm joking? I'm not joking. You wait, you see. If you're ever so lucky to sing in one of the great theaters. I'm in La Scala. I'm in Covent Garden. I'm in L'Opera. I'm in Vienna. I'm in the Metropolitan. You think it's easy? A great career? Ha! That's all I have to say to you. Ha! Is this my chair? I don't see a cushion. I asked for a cushion. Thank you. Hello. You don't look familiar. Have I seen you before? Where? When? Speak up. I can't hear you if you mumble.
We worked on Don Carlos.
I can't hear him. Can you hear him? No one can hear you.
Yesterday morning, we worked on Don Carlos together. Eboli's aria. O Don Fatale.
Was that you? You look different. You were wearing a red sweater. Where is it? It's important to have a look, a signature. Be someone so people will remember you. You all think you're so special. You're a dime a dozen. There are hundreds, not thousands of you out there studying, auditioning, going here, there, hither and yon. You expect people to remember you if you don't have a look. Po, po, po. I was never arrogant that way. I knew I needed a look, and I got one. You. Yes, you. And don't take this personally. You don't have a look. You look very nice, I'm sure you are. You look very clean, very comme il faut, but you don't have a look. Get one. Practicing your scales. Or maybe it's not. When you weigh 500 kilos, like some singers I could mention, but I won't, a look is a little more difficult. What are you smirking about? Yes, you, right behind this person without a look. You don't have a look either. In fact, I don't see anyone out there with what I consider a look. If you do, and I haven't seen you, and I don't have the best vision in the world, we'll speak more of that later. If you do, I salute you. If you don't, get one. There, bravo. Now we have the atmosphere for some serious work. Isn't that much better? Thank you. Now, we must have some rules here, otherwise chaos. This is not a circus. I really must insist on no applause, or picture takers, or autograph seekers, or late comers. All it takes is one troublemaker to spoil the concentration. You are here to observe the students, not me. Forget all about me. Poof, I'm invisible. What's your name?
Me?
Unless you want me to refer to you as the person who was wearing
our work.
Well, I'm ready. Are you? Has the heat been taken care of? I might as well be talking to myself.
They're working on it.
And I am the Grand Duchess Anastasia Romanov, and the check is in the mail. Is the first singer ready? Don't just stand there. Avanti, darling, avanti. We'll be right with you. And while you're fixing the heat and getting the cushion I requested at least three times before coming out, the last being only an hour ago, would you see if you could find a little footrest for me? You see, my feet aren't going to quite reach the ground when I sit on such an uncommonly high chair as the one you've provided me with. Thank you. I'm sure that's the last we'll see of those people, correct? I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Close your ears, child. You're just what I was talking about. I said close your ears. I don't want you to hear this. Are they closed?
Yes.
This is just what I was talking about. She doesn't have a look, poor thing. I'm not talking about her face, her figure. She can't help them. I'm talking about flair, style, elan. Even the most wretched of us can do something about them. All right, you can open them. Did you hear that?
No.
Good. Well, hello, welcome. Are you nervous?
Yes, a little.
Only a little? You should be nervous a lot. All of these people looking at you, waiting to hear what you sound like, or ready to judge you. I'd be terrified.
I am.
Well, stop it. You can't sing if you're nervous. You can't do anything if you're nervous. Nerves have destroyed more singers than a bad teacher ever did. All nerves mean is a lack of confidence, a lack of preparation. Do I make you nervous?
Yes.
Good, I take this seriously, and so should you.
I do.
Eh?
I do take this seriously.
What's your name, eh? You'll have to speak up, darling. You're on a stage now. People are listening. Hundreds and hundreds of people. They want to know who you are. Don't disappoint them. God gave you a voice. Use it.
Sophie De Palma.
Sophie De Palma. Brava. See how easy that was. Sophie De Palma, it's not an ideal name for a career, but it's good enough. I can see it outside the theater. Sophie De Palma as what? Sophie De Palma as Frasquita and Carmen. Sophie De Palma as the third Norn in Götterdämmerung. Italian?
Greek-Italian.
Bo-bo-bo!
My teacher says that accounts for my temperament. I'm very fiery.
I know.
Joke. I don't believe you can be a great artist without temperament. Neither does she. We're working on it. Everyone says that you have great temperament. I'm hoping to get some from you, frankly. Am I saying the wrong thing?
Do something fiery.
I can't, not just like that. No one can.
Where is my footstool?
Well, I guess some people can.
You thought that was fiery? Wait, just wait. My fire comes from here, Sophie. It's mine. It's not for sale. It's not for me to give away. And even if I could, I wouldn't. It's who I am. Find out who you are. That's what this is all about, eh? This is not a freak show. I am not a performing seal. I'm hoping to get some from you, Friday.
I'm sorry.
So, what are you going to sing for us to be found, ma'am?
La sonambula, alum crede ammirarti.
Brava!
Is that all right?
Into the lion's den, eh? I salute your courage, be our guest. One of the most beautiful bel canto arias, if not the most difficult.
They say you were unsurpassed in the role. I have your recording, of course. Even Sutherland.
Stop right there. This is important for all of us. I won't hear anything against any of my colleagues, and neither should you. She did her best. That's all any of us can do. Joan was, well, that's a whole other story. Like her looks, it wasn't her fault. A 12-foot Lucia de Lammermoor. Whoever heard of such a thing? But what was she to do? Stoop away from the world. I don't want this class to disintegrate into a discussion of personalities. I won't let it happen. What?
Me?
Yes, you. Who else? You've been trying to get away. Did you have a good interval? I had a friend who shall remain nameless who used to say his favorite sport of opera was the interval. Well, people like that, we're not going to concern ourselves with them today, thank God. To think there are actually people to whom beauty, art, what we do isn't important. Don't get me wrong, I think we should be paid for what we do, and some of us are paid very well. It's no secret I was paid more than any of my rivals, which was the newspaper's word for them, not mine. As if I had any. How can you have rivals when no one else can do what you can do? So much has been written about it, so much nonsense. The point I'm making, and it's a very simple one, is that art is beauty and you should be paid for it. Am I making myself clear? Never give anything away. There's no more where it came from. We give the audience everything, and when it's gone, say stop, say tu, basta, finito. We're the ones who end up empty. Ho dato tutto a te. Medea sings that to Jason when she learns he's abandoning her for another woman, a younger woman, a woman of importance. A princess. Ho dato tutto a te! I gave everything for you! Everything! That's what we artists do for people. Where would you be without us, eh? Think about that. Am I right?
I'm sorry?
He knows I'm right. And the friend who shall remain nameless, who preferred the intervals of Norma to Norma itself, was no friend. I don't know.
Hang up now!
No, Sharon. She's gone. If her skin is that thin, she's not suited for this career. It's not like I said anything about her voice. I didn't even let her open her mouth. This will make the papers. They'll have a fine time with this. Carlos hurts students' feelings. This is just what I was talking about. If you are going to stand up here naked and let people judge you, you can't afford to have feelings like Sharon's. A performance is a struggle. You have to win. The audience is the enemy. We have to bring you to your knees because we are right. If I'm worried about what you're thinking about me, I can't win. I beg, I cringe for your favor instead. Ho dato tutto a te, eh? It doesn't work that way. You have to make them beg for yours. Dominate them. Ho dato tutto a te, eh? Art is domination. It's making people think for that precise moment in time there is only one way, one voice, yours. Eh? Anyone's feelings can be hurt. Only an artist can say ho dato tutto a te center stage at La Scala, and even Leonard Bernstein forgets he's Leonard Bernstein and listens to you. Next student, please.
Start off the top of my head.
You have to listen to something in yourself to sing this difficult music. On a
was standing where Medea, Electra, Clytemnestra had stood. There was a direct line through me to the composer, to Euripides, to Medea herself. These people really existed. Lady Macbeth, Medea, or don't you believe that? Is this all make-believe to you?
I've never really thought about it.
That's because you're young. You will, in time, know how much suffering can be in store for a woman.
But you were young when you first sang Lady Macbeth and Medea.
I was never young. I couldn't afford to be, not to get where I was going. Anyway, enough of that. You came back. That's something. You have Mut. Do you know that German word? It means courage. I had to know it when I sang Fidelio for the Germans during the occupation, during the war. It was at the Theatre Herodoticus in Athens. I was 18 years old. I needed lots of Mut that day. Mut! It's a good word, don't you think? Mut! I don't like many things German, but I do like Mut! Again.
You want me to do it again?
Yes, off you go now. And this is for all of you. There are no shortcuts in art, no easy ways. This isn't life, for there are so many. There is no being at center stage as if by magic. There is always an entrance first, just as there is always an exit after. Art is about those transitions. There is only discipline, technique, and mood. The rest is cock-a-pee-pee-doo-doo. I'm sorry, but there it is. I was asked something about genius, inspiration. Well, of course, without them, we're nothing. We're a Milanov at best. Don't snicker. It was a great voice, but an artist. I don't think so. Are you ready?